There's a problem with using AI images from sites like MidJourney and leonardo.ai to create things like KDP books and other print-on-demand products. And that is, the images aren't large enough. Now, since a lot more people have been using AI to create images for their products, myself included, I've been getting a lot more messages saying that either their products have been rejected, or when their book, for example, appears on Amazon, the images look blurry. So we're going to look at what this problem is, and I'm going to give you a couple of solutions that are both fast and currently free. So what is the problem? What does this image not being large enough actually mean? So if we go to our image generating platform, in this case MidJourney, click on our image, right click, save the image to our computer, and then open it, we can gather some information from our image by clicking on this little information icon. And the thing we want to look at is this here, which is the image DPI, or dots per inch, which in this case says 72 pixels per inch. Now you might see it being referred to as PPI, pixels per inch, or DPI, dots per inch. In our case, both of them are equivalent. Strictly speaking, pixels per inch is for screens, dots per inch is per print, but as I said, they're both interchangeable. Now, if you go to the KDP help section and look at the requirements for a book cover and interior, and the same for other print-on-demand sites, whether it's things like t-shirts, mugs, whatever, you'll find that the requirements are usually 300 dots per inch. But here, we've only got 72 dots per inch. In practice, what this means is this. We've got a book cover image here with an aspect ratio of 8.5 to 11. Now note, I didn't say 8.5 inches to 11 inches, but an aspect ratio of 8.5 to 11. And this comes out to an image of a width of 960 pixels by 1,248 pixels. Now at 72 dots per inch, that means this image has an effective size of 13.33 inches by 17.33 inches. So if you're to use this as is, it wouldn't meet those requirements of the print-on-demand platform. And in fact, as I said earlier, the images may come out blurry, or you might get your product rejected. So what could we do to solve this problem? Well, if we were to take our image and reduce it in size, and say, for instance, we reduce the width by half and the height by half, now we've got the same number of pixels, but into a smaller space. So in fact, now we'd have an image equivalent of around 144 dots per inch. And in fact, we can go to a pixels to inches converter. So we have our width of 960 pixels by 1,248 pixels, 72 dots per inch gives us that width that we just mentioned, 13.33 by 17.33. So if we reduce the size of our image to make it 300 dots per inch, which is what we need for print, calculate that, we come out with an actual image size of 3.2 inches by 4.16 inches. Now that's a lot smaller in this example than a book cover of 8.5 inches by 11 inches. Might be okay if you were using that image maybe on something like a mug or a phone case. So what can we do about it? Well, there are a couple of options, and it really depends on, one, what software you're going to be creating your book covers and interiors or products in, and two, the type of image, whether it's an illustration or a photo type image. So if we're going to be using software, vector editing software like Adobe Illustrator, Affinity Designer, or Inkscape, we can convert our image into a vector image. Now, I like using vector images, and the beauty of them is that they can be enlarged infinitely, if you like, and they don't pixelate or get blurry. I'll show you an example. On the left here is a pixel image that's been enlarged, and you can see it's become what they call pixelated compared to the image on the right, which is a vector image where the lines stay nice and sharp and clear. So we can use this tool here at a site called Vectorizer.ai. Now, currently, this is free of charge to use. And it's just a case of dragging our image into Vectorizer, letting it do its work. And here we have on the left our original image, and on the right our vector image. And as I've just showed you, if we enlarge that, we can see on the left it becomes pixelated, on the right it stays nice and sharp. So we can just click on download, make sure fill shapes is selected in the draw style, and just hit download. So now it's easy enough just to take that image and drag it into our vector editing software, in this case Affinity Designer, and then we can just use this on our book cover, interior, whatever we like, and it will remain nice and sharp. And then when we save that as a PDF print file, it will be in the correct number of dots per inch, 300 dots per inch, and it'll be nice and crisp. Now, as I said, this is only useful for illustration type images. And what I mean by that are images like these, as opposed to things like photographs. So we come on to the second scenario, and that is if you're using images that are more photograph-like, or you want to use software like Canva, then we need to take a different approach. And we need to do what's called upscale our image. Because if we were to go to Vectorizer and put in a photograph image like this lion's face image here, which was actually created in MidJourney, and we enlarge it, you can see that it loses a lot of the detail of the subtle shading that we would usually find in a photograph. Now, this may be okay if you're after this particular effect, but normally we want to use a different method. So we're going to use a site called bigjpg.com. And again, at the moment, this is currently free to use, but in the free version, it does have a couple of limitations. One, it is slightly slower, but not too slow. Two, there's a limit to the maximum size of the image you can upload. And also on the free version, it doesn't save your images to their platform. But you know, if you are downloading it to your computer, it doesn't really matter. So like Vectorizer, it's just a case of just dragging your image into BigJPG, then hitting start, select artwork or photo. In this case, it's an illustration, so we're going to stick to artwork. Now the upscaling, we want to do it four times so that when we then bring it down to the size of the image that we want to use on our product, it then has the correct number of dots per inch, and we can leave noise reduction as none. And once that's done, you can then hit download. And so now you can drag that image into Canva or Photoshop or whatever software you're using. Now, apparently, Photoshop can also upscale images, but there are quite a number of steps that you do need to go through. Using BigJPG is quicker, and apparently, according to their site, it does produce better quality images than doing it in Photoshop. So over in Canva, we've got our two images here. At the top, we've got our original image that was downloaded straight from MidJourney, and at the bottom here, we've got our upscaled image that we've downloaded from BigJPG. Now, you may not be able to see here on the screen, but the bottom image from BigJPG is actually a bit more vibrant. There's a bit more saturation in the image. Now, what we can do is just enlarge those two images to see if there is any noticeable difference. So we'll go all the way to 500 and we'll have a look at this area here on the door. So you can see that's quite pixelated. But on our upscaled image, the lines look a lot sharper. So although the images that you actually download from BigJPG are 72 dots per inch, because they're really big images, by the time you shrink them down to the size that we need for our products, whether it's a book or t-shirt, whatever, they then become adequate enough. They become 300 dots per inch or higher. And then in the case of Canva, once you've created your cover, you then download that as a PDF print file, which will be 300 dots per inch, but it'll be a much crisper and sharper image, which will, at the end of the day, give you better images. So this is not a particularly exciting area of book creation or print on demand creation, but it is an important part nevertheless if you are wanting to create good quality products and products that don't get rejected when you try and submit them. Now, if you are new to this print-on-demand business, creating KDP books, then I suggest starting on my book tutorials playlist here, where I go through all the steps similar to this of creating and uploading books to Amazon. Thank you much for your time. It is very much appreciated. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button. And until next time, goodbye.